In this tutorial, I'd like to discuss the difference between value parameters, which we've seen up to this point in the course, and reference parameters, which are the topic of discussion for this tutorial. Consider the following program. I've changed the function doIt to take an integer parameter of type int. The name of the parameter is p. And all doIt does is assign the value 20 to the parameter p. Here in the function main, I have a variable called x. I assign it a value 10. Obviously, the value of x before we output the obviously the value of x before we make a call to doIt is output as the value 10. Then we call doIt with that variable called x. And the question is, after we call doIt, did the value of x get changed to 20 or not? Let's run the program and find out. So as before, we see that x before the call to doIt is 10, and x after the call to doIt is 10. In other words, assigning a value to one of the parameters of the function doIt did not change the value of the actual parameter in main. The way to think about that is in the usual situation, the normal situation, the variables inside doIt and the parameters, in fact, are copies of the variables in the main program. So I have a variable in the main program called x. I have a parameter in doIt called p. P is a copy of x. doIt certainly changes the value of the copy to 20, but the original value of x is unchanged, and in the case of this program, that value remains 10, as you just saw. Now let's just make a small but very important change. I'm going to uncomment that declaration and comment this one out. These are the function prototypes, and I'll change the header here. Okay. The only thing I've changed here is to insert a very subtle ampersand right before the name of that parameter p. The type is still int, but the parameter p is said to be a reference parameter. And the way to read that is p is now a reference to the variable x. It's not a copy of x, it's a reference to x. It's a synonym for x, a pseudonym for x. Some people call it an alias for x. There are two names for exactly the same thing. P refers to x. It's just like saying you can call me Colin, you can call me Goebel. It's the same person. Colin refers to the person Goebel. In this case, P refers to x, and in the book it's called a reference parameter. You indicate that fact with the ampersand. It makes a big difference. If we run this program now, you'll notice that after the call, x did in fact get changed to 20. So we can see that an assignment to p, setting p to 20, in this case had exactly the same effect as if we'd set the variable up here, x, to 20. To summarize, p is a reference parameter, p refers to x. And we indicate that we want it treated that way with the ampersand sign right there before the parameter name. Thank you.